Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the regular business meeting of Reading City Council here on Monday, September 9th. We are going to open this evening's meeting with the invocation by, from Zach.
Bougay,
I'm sorry, Zach. And he's from the Conference of Churches. We're going to remain standing at that point for the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag.
Thank you. Heavenly Father, we come to you today asking for your guidance, wisdom, and support as we begin this meeting. Help us to engage in meaningful discussion, Lord. Allow us to grow closer as a group and nurture the bonds of this community. Fill us with your grace as we make decisions that might affect the students, the citizens, the businesses, the children, and visitors of Reading, Pennsylvania. And continue to remind us, Father, that all we do here today, all that we accomplish, is for the pursuit of truth, for the greater glory of you, Father, and for the service of humanity. Lord, we seek blessings on the tasks that are before us today. Bless our efforts, Lord, with clear insight, our sharpness of mind, our deliberations with wisdom, our work with clarity and accuracy, and our decisions with impartiality. Father, in Proverbs 15:22, it says, "Without counsel, plans fail, but with many advisors, they succeed." I ask for special blessings on each and every one of these city council members here today. And I thank you for them, and I ask that you bless this meeting, Father. In your name, amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I'm sure Carol Riley's going to tell us.
Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Ms. Cepeda Freitas?
Here.
Ms. Goodman-Henderschitz?
Here.
Mr. Marmaru?
Here.
Ms. Reed?
Here.
Ms. Shihelnik?
Here.
Mr. Twyman?
Present.
Mr. Waltman, president?
Here.
Seven present, none absent.
Just to update the public, we had executive sessions on August 26th and September 3rd related to contracts, litigation, and personnel relevant to the Pennsylvania Sunshine Act, Section 108A1, 3, and 4. There are no proclamations or presentations this evening. That takes us right into public comment. Council, we have 8 speakers on non-agenda items. Is there any objection to hearing them at this time? If there's not, I'm going to ask that Councilwoman Reed please read our public comment guidelines.
Okay, thank you, Mr. President. The Administrative Code, Section 5-209, defines public participation at council meetings. Citizens attending council meetings are expected to conduct themselves in a responsible and respectful manner that does not disrupt the meeting. Those wishing to have conversations should do so in a hallway outside City Council chambers with a low speaking voice. Public comment will occur during the public comment period listed in the agenda at the podium and must be directed to council as a body and not to any individual council member or public or elected official in attendance. Those speaking on agenda matters have 5 minutes, on non-agenda matters, 3 minutes. Clapping, calling out, and or cheering when a speaker finishes his comments is not permitted. Citizens may not approach the council tables at any time during the meeting. Any person making threats of any type, personally offensive or impertinent remarks, or any person becoming unruly while addressing council may be called to order by the presiding officer and may be barred from speaking, removed from council members, council chambers, and or cited. Those with materials to distribute to council members should give them to our interim auditor, Maria Rodriguez, sitting over there with her hand up. I'm sorry, I got to coordinate better with you. And failure to abide by these regulations could result in your removal from council chambers and or citation. These regulations are meant to avoid disruptions at the meeting, and they are not meant to interfere with public participation.
All right, thank you, Donna. Our first speaker this evening is Donald Laura, and the topic is robberies and homeless. Donald, good evening, sir. Welcome, you have up to 3 minutes.
We citizens of Reading are getting tired of these prostitutes are robbing us, and we're getting a little bit tired of it. and the homeless people. They're always coming around asking, can we borrow a dollar? Can we borrow this? Can we borrow that? Can we borrow this? This is getting to be a nonsense. See, I work for my money, and we have to give it to the homeless, and that's kind of like not right. And then the third thing I was going to add with the police, they ain't out there kind of like doing their job, doing like patrolling the areas and everything. And the fourth thing I'd like to add, a couple of nights ago, there was a drag race, like around 3-4 o'clock in the morning, and I live on Washington Street. And then I hear like kids are yelling, screaming, and there's car racing and everything. And this is, they should not be doing it like that time of the night.
Okay, Donald, we appreciate your input. Council will have an opportunity to reply to you after the public comment period or at the end of the meeting. We don't typically reply at this time, so we thank you for the information. It's very helpful, okay?
Am I dismissed?
If you have more to say, you have an additional time.
Thank you.
Thank you, Donald. All right, our next speaker is Melissa Reinhardt, and the topic is homelessness. Hi, Melissa. Good evening. You have up to 3 minutes.
Yes. I want to speak about homelessness for women. Women do not have places to go in this city if they cannot get into Berks, safe Berks, because they are a battered woman. They only have the opportunity house to go to, and if the opportunity house does not accept them, they don't have anywhere to go to. Granted, yes, I am at the Opportunity House right now, but the Opportunity House has me on a stipulation that I'm only allowed to be there from 7 at night to 7 in the morning. Why Delia has that set, I'll never know. But if it's pouring down rain at night or during the daytime, where am I to go if nothing's open? And there has to be something more open than just Opportunity House for homeless women. Granted, I'm told that there is something coming next year, but we can't wait till next year. We need something done now.
All right, Melissa, appreciate the information. I think council will take that under consideration. We will have an opportunity to respond to you,
okay,
either after the public comment period or at the end of the meeting.
Okay.
Did you have additional comments? Because you do.
I do want to say one more thing.
Sure.
You can't judge all homeless people by one person coming up and begging you for money.
Okay, thank you, Melissa.
You're welcome.
Our next speaker is Carol Riley, and the topic is pertaining to the City Council meeting on August 26, I believe it says, Carol. Good evening, and you have up to 3 minutes.
3 minutes? All right, good evening, City Council, community. My question is for right now, City Council, is the people for the community, as well as anyone else, in the city of Reading, okay? I want the God's honest truth right now. You know what happened last week. If somebody was not here, I had a seizure, okay? And again, it didn't helpful. And I'll tell you right now, I'm very hurt and very upset about all this stuff. But I want the God's honest truth. That's why I left those things there. I don't know if you're allowed to use them or not. But if you have faith and trust in yourself, then use them then, please. It's in Spanish and English, saying yes, and C for yes, and no, yes it is. No, I didn't put that, no, I put the other ones for the community and everything, but I didn't put it out right now for that. So let me just finish, please. But I want to get this place moving and grooving, this whole community. Right now, no one's gave me a chance at all. I mean, I'm talking about with the school, basically the school district. I've been doing this since 2013, like I told you before, okay? Starting with the daycares, number one. Get them at an early age. When you start them at early age, that's when they get moving and grooving. Back to what I'm saying. Right now, for the, you know, from daycare to 12th grade, there's too many things going on between bullying and negativity. And the way we needed things is we needed to make things more positive, more fun at school. Right now, I don't see hardly any of that stuff. I don't even see it in the streets. I just see these bicycles and everything, all that stuff. It's not happening. Right now, there's too much blind faith, it's called. People don't believe in you, they don't see you, whatever. The only person I want to give faith and trust to right now that saw me and took action right away was Mr. Ralph Johnson, and I thank him very much. Right now, I have a question for you all, City Council. When I end up, I was fine, because there's all different kinds of seizures, and not just one, okay? Mine's out, in and out. Yes, I couldn't see what I was doing, but you know at that point? No one needed it. I did not need to go to the ER room. I let the ambulance squad gentlemen know I don't need to go. Somebody told me I need to go. So who's going to pay that ambulance bill? You tell me. You all. Turn the tables. Be in my shoes. I've been patient enough about all this and how many years. So please, please take this in consideration. It's not just for me. It's for anybody in the whole community. So I thank you.
Thank you, Carol.
You're welcome.
Our next speaker is Angel Torres. Hold on a second there, Angel Young. I didn't have a topic, Angel, if you wanted to just... Okay. Let him hold the mic and come to the side of the podium. Angel, you can come to the side of the podium. That'd be great. There you go.
Right.
Thank you. You have 3 minutes, Angel. Take your time.
Good evening, Council. City of Reading, everybody on city on TV land. I got it, Ralph. Thank you. Well, my name is Angel Torres. I am here representing the Consumer Action Group at Abilities in Motion. As a citizen of Reading, as citizens of Reading, we request that City Council make timely decisions to appropriate funds for the improvement of infrastructure of the city. Utilizing funds in a manner that shows concern and awareness for the needs of the citizens of this city. Improving the sidewalks of our city is a major undertaking, and there are many variables to consider. Our old brick sidewalks, trees, whether it be the tree roots or the tree stumps causing the issue, there is deteriorating cement sidewalks. The list is long. Improving routes to school for the youth. Removing barriers for the elderly and handicapped. Encouraging safe and enjoyable utilization of the areas for the of the area trails and pathways for the walking, hiking, and bicycling pedestrians of our community. There has been plenty of discussion and planning regarding these ideas. As City Council, you are the ones who make the decisions to proceed with the plans to improve the infrastructure, to improve infrastructure, with the plans to improve infrastructure become, okay. As City Council, you are the ones who make the decisions to proceed with the plans to improve infrastructure that becomes realization. We ask that City Council make the decision. That's my.
Thank you. Thank you, Angel.
I am also a member of We the People, citizens. Thank you.
Thank you.
Wait, record. There we go.
All right, our next speaker is.
I forgot one last little thing.
Sure.
I still have a couple of minutes.
Oh, go ahead.
Okay. Now, concerning epilepsy, which I think what Carol was trying to say, with the help of the Epilepsy Foundation of Eastern Pennsylvania, education about epilepsy can be brought to the city of Reading, the police, the EMS, the school district, etc. They just need to know that you want this education. Thank you.
Thank you, Angel. Our next speaker is Anne-Marie Wolf, and the topic is We the People. Anne-Marie, you have up to 3 minutes. Good evening. Do you want to adjust that microphone?
Okay.
Thank you.
When people are physically active, it helps their mind and thoughts positive. Wait a minute. Positive because the actions help you feel better. To give an example, my philosophy is to clean up who you are angry at or someone you are angry at, pretend that you are cleaning up the person, their face up on what you're cleaning, and watch off your mind. It works for me. It works for you. See if it works for you. It works for me. This has allowed you to clear mind, and when you would think of a lot better and behave a lot better. And another example is parking in handicapped spaces. If you're not handicapped, how would you feel if you could not walk at a long distance and you get hurt trying? Peacefulness happens when you get along with others. This makes you happy, and when you are happy, other people are happy. Please be good citizens to one another, and God will continue to bless you.
Thank you, Anne-Marie. Our next speaker is Reverend Evelyn Morrison, and the topic is contamination and ADA requirements, is it? Good evening, Evelyn. You have up to 3 minutes.
Council members, I want to be brief. We the people citizens request that a trained medical personnel be present at all city council or public meetings for the safety and welfare of each citizen attending public meetings, especially those who have disabilities. In light of the episode while in a meeting and subsequently recent death of former District 6 council member John Slifko, as well as the stress-induced episode of citizen Carol Riley while attending a city council meeting, it warrants the need for this request for a medical trained person to be present. Although the fire chief and the police chief were in attendance, neither could offer any medical assistance to Ms. Riley. Fortunately, she was able to be sustained until the EMTs arrived and transported her to the hospital. The insistent statements from a council person repeatedly stating, "I know about this, you know I know about this," which offered very little assistance to Ms. Riley, coupled with an insensitive attitude of a city clerk only interested in finishing the 1 minute remainder of the public comments. This demonstrates literally a cold and helpless and aloof care for persons with disability. Ms. Riley has consistently requested action and consensus from the City Council to address the needs of persons with disabilities, and specifically persons who have epileptic episodes who have every right to engage in the civic process. We, the citizens, demand a resolution in favor of the health, safety, and welfare of each citizen that attends any and all public meetings. We, the people, citizens, expect a follow-up to this request in writing from the mayor and the city council president and members before the next council meeting. Now, we have an ADA policy, but it only deals with physical disabilities. They present it as Exhibit A. And when you look at it, it only deals with physical disabilities. It needs to be updated, and it definitely needs to be brought up to 2019. There are a lot more cases being brought to Superior and Supreme Court regarding the accommodations. The executive order of 2000 stated that it was necessary for any agency that receives any federal funds to be able to have this access policy and procedures in place so that they continue to receive those federal funds. The city is that such agency or such government. So I just want us to be mindful of that. And then if you would indulge me for 30 more seconds to talk about the activity coming up on Thursday.
Give me a moment. Anybody opposed to 30 more seconds for Evelyn at this time? Go ahead, Evelyn. You have
30 seconds. I invite all of you to come to the third floor Thursday at 5:30. It is the launching of the Afro-Latino History Celebration. We would love to raise the multicultural flags in front of City Hall and have a little conga drumming and some balloon flying to celebrate the history and the contributions of the Afro-Latino community. We also want to remind you that Saturday is the African parade and festivities. So this launches our multicultural celebration that highlights our brothers and sisters of Latino and African descent. So all of you are welcome. The last time I checked, all of you possess the DNA of the African. Thank you.
Thank you, Evelyn. Our final speaker is David Rodriguez and Jobs for the City of Reading. Hey, David, good evening, sir. You have up to 3 minutes.
I greet you all in the name of Jesus Christ. There's a scripture in the Bible where it says, when I was in jail, you didn't visit me. When I was naked, you didn't clothe me. When I was thirsty, you gave me no drink. Basically, what's going on, that we're all supposed to be brothers and sisters, but we lack because we have a job, we have a roof over our head, so you don't care about your neighbor. Basically, you don't, because you're doing good. Now, if you were in the same situation as a person needing a job, then you'd be on that person's shoes. I agree with the person about people asking for money, but if there's no job, they have no choice. You know, I lived in New York, I was homeless at one time, and I said, can you buy me a sandwich? And the person says, go get an effing job. That wasn't the right, that's not the right attitude to have to a homeless person. If you're hungry and you see your brother and feed, there was three Pharisees, it's called the Good Samaritan. They saw this poor man dying in the street, and they just walked over it. And it took this Good Samaritan to take that person, put him in a hotel, and he paid for the hotel. He paid for the food. So we have to have a conscience for others. We could point that at people, but these three fingers are pointing back at us. So it's time for us to do what needs to be done as a human. That's what I got.
Thank you. Council, that ends the public comment section. I'm going to remind everyone, if there's an immediate need to respond, that one person responds on a specific subject, we don't have to repeat the same comments, and then we'll have an extended chance to speak at the end of the meeting. I am going to start off with making a brief comment. And what happened at our last meeting was very unfortunate. I will not accept the fact that anybody believes that anybody on the body felt anything less than that. We spend a lot of our time as volunteers looking out for the safety and health and welfare of everyone in the city. including making sure we fund an effective police and fire and EMS department. We have some of the best, if not the best, in the county. In most cases, in 3 minutes or less, they're able to get to you and help stabilize you. It is unfortunate that we can't have somebody on every corner for every need. And there's a lot of people with stress in this city, obviously, from every process of life. I also feel the comments about the homeless are right on, that there are a lot of people out there in need, and we should never turn a shoulder to them. We're all in this together. Some of us grew up very poor. I know how much a little bit of help went in the deepest times of need. And sometimes it's hard for people to even ask, and I think it's important to remember that, because the ask is harder than even doing without in many cases. So I just want to make those comments. If anybody has anything pressing at this time to any of the speakers, certainly now we can do that, or we can wait to the end of the meeting. Go ahead, John.
The last meeting we were in, and I'm sorry, Carol, and I hope that you're feeling better. And however, the way things occurred, I think we were all very concerned. And those that, you know, all of us did not want to rush to the door to help you, because the people that could help you were there, and we wanted to give you air and breathing space. And we knew that by removing ourselves and allowing those experts to help you out was the best thing to do. I think everyone in here was very concerned about you. You know, you are here all the time. You know, we admire your perseverance. And, you know, we were all very concerned. So I don't know that things happened the way, you know, with all due respect, Ms. Morrison, I don't know that they happened the way you described, because I think we were all concerned. We made sure to go into recess, and we waited because we wanted to make sure that Carol's needs were met before we continued with our agenda. So I just want you to know that we do care about you, and we are concerned, and we will do everything possible to meet the needs of many. But as Jeff, I want to reiterate and stress what Jeff said, you know, we are all volunteers, and we do have our city's best interest at heart. So I don't want you to think by any means that we are not concerned and we don't care. We will do everything in our power to do what's best.
We're not going to have interaction, but maybe after the meeting, Carol, okay. Any other comments at this time? Marcia, I'm sorry.
And for me, I appreciate what Carol experienced 2 weeks ago. I had that happen to me several different times in public settings. And fortunately, just as there was for Carol, there was appropriate EMS responses. I am moving forward working with the Berks County Medical Society to be able to do some more public education. I reached out to the chief after the meeting to talk about what more we can be doing in the name of education. It's a chronic health condition, and there needs to be more awareness of understanding. I'm not sure all the people sitting here at this table would even know if I was going into a petite mall. Obviously, you understand and you can see what happens when a person goes into a grand mall, but what Carol experiences was somewhat different, so that it is a challenge too, by the way, when EMS do transport you, there is a cost associated with that, so there's a lot of factors, but I think the education is the key. So respectfully, I did what I felt I needed to do as a concerned, compassionate person, and unfortunately, I do not know why certain people that spoke did not respect what I was attempting to do, because it brought in some traumatic feelings for myself when I stepped forward. Thank you.
All right, Council. Any other immediate needs at this time? Go ahead, Donna.
I just want to, since the question of, or the, John's name was brought up, when that happened, REMS was there, what, 5 minutes, 4 minutes? John was not in, at that point, in huge distress, but they couldn't have been more accommodating. Everything was done just the right way, and probably their quick action got him to that hospital and gave him to us for another few days. So I have nothing but good things to say about our response time and our EMS people. And where we sit here at 8th and Washington Streets, they are very close by, and they are here literally, what was that, 3 minutes, if that was,
yep.
Not even 3 minutes.
All right, any other comments at this time? If not, we're going to move on to the approval of our agenda and minutes. Includes the minutes from our August 26 regular meeting. It also is approving the summation of our discussions from the August 26 Committee of the Whole meeting, and September 3rd Strategic Planning Committee of the Whole, and Nominations and Appointments Committee meetings. It also would include the approval of our consent agenda, which is, has just one item this evening, that is authorizing the disposal of contract documents from the city clerk's office in accordance with the Pennsylvania Record Retention Policy as listed. Is there any objection to the approval of our agenda and minutes and consent agenda at this time? All right, if not, they stand as approved. We're going to move on to our administrative report, and we'll welcome Managing Director Osborne. Good evening, Osborne.
Thank you, Mr. President. The administration is continuing negotiations with the IFF and the FOP. We've recently had frequent input from the Act 47 folks as we plot along and doing our best to avoid arbitration this time. City administration continues to have meetings with Public Works to continue with the River Road extension, and also we recently met with respect to our allocations with CDBG. Finally, I would like to note that the city is having its 9/11 memorial event on, of course, 9/11, which is this Wednesday at 9:55 a.m. This will take place at City Park. I've looked at the forecast. It's 91 degrees is what we're scheduled to have, so dress accordingly. If in the unlikely event we have inclement weather by way of rain, then the event will be here. And that's the end of my report, Mr. President.
All right. Any comments or questions for the Managing Director? Go ahead, Johanny.
I have a question. What's the status of the greenhouse?
We recently hired Kyle Zieber, who used to actually, he starred as a horticulturalist with the city when we hired him over a couple decades ago, I believe. And one of the things that he said in the interview, which led to his hiring, was how he wanted to start working on it and restore it. So I actually had that conversation this afternoon with the mayor, and I'm glad you brought that up because I was going to follow up with Mr. Zieber and Rolf on that as well.
And the reason why I ask, I was at a meeting this morning, and something related to the greenhouse was mentioned as far as an RFP. Is there some RFP for the greenhouse?
As I recall, when Glenn was the managing director, I believe that there were discussions to see if we could get into a partnership with the Higher Learning Institute, mm-hmm, with respect to the greenhouse. I wasn't tasked with that, so I'll have to look into that to see where it was. With respect to what's being done specifically with the greenhouse, I'm not aware of any RP, but I'll look into that. I do know that when I had discussions about this with the Public Works Director, that there that the stained glass was in need of being replaced eventually, as it is it's not, I believe, allowing the correct amount of light to get into for the greenhouse to function effectively.
All right, any other comments or questions for the Managing Director? Go ahead, Brian.
Yeah, in regards to the 9/11 celebrations, did we decide as to the air raid sirens, are they going to be used or not?
Mm-hmm. I think the Fire Chief can speak on that.
No, this year,
thank you.
All right, any other questions? If not, we're going to move on to the report from our interim city auditor. Maria, good evening. Welcome.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good evening. My report tonight is on the 2019 cable franchise fee. Every year, the city received every quarter revenue from Comcast Cable. This year, for the first two quarters, the city has received $419,622.09, and the city budgeted for 2019, $875,000. For the previous 4 years, the city had exceeded the budget expectation, except in 2018, when the city had a negative variance of $79,000. for the real estate transfer pass. As August 31st, the city has received $3,171,590.77. For this year, the city budgeted $3.8 million. Looking the previous 4 years, the city exceeded the expectation for the budget. And we had a positive variance for the previous 4 years. Also, I just want to say that by looking the merit bills, I noticed that the city had a large credit in one of the public property account. I got in contact with Mr. Kelly, Jamar Kelly, and he followed up. And on September the 3rd, the city got refunded $14,801.66 from Meret. I want to say thank you to Mr. Kevin Lugo and Madeline Collins and Mr. Jamar Kelly for following up. We got the money. Nice. Thank you.
All right, thank you, Maria. Any comments or questions for Maria this evening? Yes, go ahead, Joanna.
Thank you. Thank you, Maria, for that.
You're welcome.
I appreciate it. I love it when we get refunds and money into the city. A quick question regarding the cable franchise fees. Just curiosity. Mm-hmm. Is that something that, can we negotiate cable fees for our constituents? Like, is there a possibility? I mean, we're collecting franchise fees for them to operate business in the city. I'm just curious if we have that power to, you know, since they are operating. I mean, I don't know if I'm, is that the right?
No, we don't have that.
I don't think we do. I can check into that, but I don't think we do. The fix is set. We receive a percentage-wide based on what they collect for what they charge to the customers.
What is the percentage that they?
I don't have that with me. I can find out and let you know later. Yeah.
Curious.
Yeah.
They charge a lot of money, so I'm just curious.
Franchise fee is negotiated in the contract.
Right. Isn't that like a 10-year contract, I think? Or it's a lengthy one, I know that.
It expires in a few years.
Yeah.
Okay, so any other comments or questions? So Maria, it looks like if we fall short a little bit on the franchise fees, we'll make it up with the transfer taxes.
Yes.
So
yes.
It wipes it.
But
wipes
I think we're other. Doing, so far we're going good with the franchise fee too, based on what was budgeted, because we budgeted less in 2019 that was the city budget in 2018. But I think we have collected $419,000 so far, and we budgeted $875,000. So I believe we are in
track. We're pretty close. Yeah, pretty close. Yep. Marcia?
Yeah, and I think that one of the things we may want to look at, people are looking at other ways of receiving television signals beyond just Comcast now, just because of the rates and such. And as we project revenues in the future, we may need to take that into consideration, that there may not be as many people that are using Comcast as a means of television reception.
All right, any other comments or questions? If not, we're going to move on to ordinances from, we don't have any reports from the board's authorities or commissions this evening. We're going to move on to ordinances for final passage. The first ordinance is bill number 27-2019 to amend the city code by eliminating the oversight of the IT division by both the administrative services and the managing director sections of the city code and listing oversight of the IT division under the managing director only. That was introduced at the August 12th regular meeting. It was tabled at the August 26th regular meeting. Is there a motion, please?
So moved.
Second.
It's been properly moved and seconded. Are there any comments? So this is just a point of clarification. There was some duplicity in reference as to who that individual would report to. And this clarifies it for the administration to eliminate any confusion. Anybody have additional comments? All right, Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Reed, seconded by Councilor Goodman-Henrichetz to enact Bill Number 27-2019, which amends the city code by eliminating the oversight of the IT division by both administrative services and the managing director. Mrs. Peter Freitas?
No.
Ms. Goodman-Henrichetz?
Yes.
Mr. Marmorow?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
No.
Ms. Shalnick?
No.
Mr. Twyman?
No.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
Three yeas, four nays.
All right, the next ordinance is Bill Number 31-2019, amending the general fund budget by transferring $33,075 from accounting division salaries to administrative services director temporary wages to fund the administrative assistant position. This was introduced at the August 26 regular meeting. Are there any comments?
Motion.
So moved. Sorry, is there a motion? I apologize.
Yep.
I was stumbled by the last ordinance. Sorry. I'm still thinking about that one. It's been properly moved and seconded. Are there any comments? It's pretty self-explanatory, right? All right, Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Reed, seconded by Councilor Shelnick to enact Bill Number 31-2019, which authorizes a transfer in the budget between fire.
Bill Number 31.
Bill Number 31, between the accounting division and the administrative services director. Ms. Goodman-Hinderschitz?
Yes.
Mr. Marmaru?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Ms. Shalnick?
Yes.
Mr. Twyman?
Yes.
Ms. Cepeda-Freitas?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
7 yeas, no nays.
The next ordinance is Bill Number 32-2019, amending the general fund budget, transferring a total of $65,000 in the fire budget to fund the emergency replacement of the personnel protective clothing of firefighters that was condemned following a recent fire incident involving hazardous materials. This was introduced at the August 26 regular meeting. Is there a motion, please?
So moved.
It's been properly moved and seconded. Are there any comments?
No, just that this was done after the fire. Our firefighters had to respond to a call in which their equipment was damaged beyond repair, and this allows firefighters, when this equipment is replaced, to be able to respond to future catastrophic events.
Absolutely. All right, any other comments? Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Cepeda-Freitas, seconded by Councilor Marmaru, to enact Bill Number 32-2019, which authorizes a transfer of $65,000 in the fire budget to allow the replacement of protective clothing. Mr. Marmaru?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Ms. Shalnick? Mr. Twyman?
Yes.
Ms. Cepeda-Freitas?
Yes.
Ms. Goodman-Hinderschitz?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
7 yeas, no nays.
Our next ordinance is Bill Number 33-2019, amending the general fund budget, transferring $21,723.77 from Public Works contracted services to police criminal investigation to reimburse the police pension fund for costs associated with payments owed to officers and retirees derived from arbitration settlement. The cost will be funded by a reallocation of unspent budgeted funds from public works projects that will not occur during the fiscal year. This was introduced at the August 26 regular meeting. Is there a motion, please?
So moved.
Second.
All right, are there any comments?
Again, this just funds the what was necessary to, which was result of a grievance.
And really, this is just proactively taking kind of unused monies out of Public Works this year before they fall into the fund balance and just reallocating them.
Correct.
To this specific need. All right, Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Marmaru, seconded by Councilor Reed, to enact Bill Number 33-2019, which authorizes a budget transfer to satisfy an arbitration settlement. Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Ms. Shalnick?
Yes.
Mr. Twyman?
Yes.
Ms. Cepeda-Freitas?
Yes.
Ms. Goodman-Hinderschitz?
Yes.
Mr. Marmaru?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
7 yeas, no nays.
Our next ordinance is Bill Number 34-2019, amending the general fund budget, transferring $18,368.48 from the self-insurance fund to Public Works Garage for insurance claims. This was introduced at the August 26 regular meeting. Is there a motion, please?
So moved.
Second.
It's been properly moved and seconded. Are there any comments?
Self-explanatory.
Pretty much self-explanatory. All right. Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Reed, seconded by Councilor Twyman, to enact Bill Number 34-2019, which authorizes a budget transfer to reimburse Public Works for insurance claims. Ms. Schelnick?
Yes.
Mr. Twyman?
Yes.
Mrs. Peter Freitas?
Yes.
Ms. Goodman Henschitz?
Yes.
Mr. Marmarou?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
Seven yeas, no nays.
Our final ordinance for passage this evening is Bill Number 35-2019, authorizing the implementation of the Sidewalk Repair and Replacement Pilot Program, utilizing the funds allocated for those purposes in the annual general fund budget. This was introduced at the August 26th regular meeting. Is there a motion, please?
So moved.
It's been properly moved and seconded and third and fourth.
Who seconded
it? I had Johanny, yeah.
Okay. So
it's been properly moved and seconded. Are there any comments?
Just that the administration looks forward to implementing this program and getting and this pilot program, seeing how it works and getting some much-needed sidewalks repaired in the city already.
Marcia?
First of all, I wanted to thank the administration for really doing their diligence in coming up with a very balanced approach. It is a pilot program, but we're looking at need. I think it speaks to one of the gentlemen that expressed a concern in public comment about the condition of sidewalks, so certainly the accessibility will be a consideration, as well as working together with the neighborhoods to develop what could then be a pilot program, assessing its effectiveness, and then based on the findings, being able to come up with a full program. But I like the approach. I want to thank David Grant for taking the leadership in this, and certainly, again, vetting it with council. It's the way government should work, listening to public input, making adjustments based on council response, and then moving forward with the final ordinance.
Johanny, and then Lucy.
Thank you. I want to emphasize, I'm grateful, to the administration for presenting it in a manner in which it makes sense and how it's going to be implemented. I do want to just mention to everyone that I did meet with the Abilities and Motions, when the topic was first being discussed, and they have been very proactive in using the iRequest app in identifying sidewalks that directly impact their constituents. So I have forwarded that information to David Hunter, because the sidewalk repair pilot program, it is a first come, first serve, as I understand it. However, priority will be given to the elderly and people with disabilities. So that's it. Thank you.
Lucy.
Yeah, I wanted to thank Mr. Torres for coming out and his direct advocacy for speaking tonight. I know I see you not only here often, but other community meetings all over the city, and accessibility is important and it's vital for all of our residents. So thank you.
Donna?
And just echoing and supporting what everyone said, collaboration is what every good government needs. And on this one, everyone from citizens to council to the administration weighed in. I think it's probably as equitable a program going forward as pilot as we're going to see, and it will be interesting to see how we look at it when the initial program's done.
Bye.
I do also want to praise the administration and council and all those involved who have been able to put forth this program. I think what's most important about it is that we will be looking at it as a pilot, and hopefully we'll be able to do way better in the future. This is just a small example of things we should be able to do, and if we do them well, we will expand them throughout the city. So hats off to the administration and council and everyone, and I hope we do a great job.
Okay, any other comments? All right, Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Twyman, seconded by Councilor Cepeda Freitas to enact Bill Number 35-2019, which authorizes the creation of a sidewalk repair replacement program. Mr. Twyman?
Yes.
Ms. Cepeda Freitas?
Yes.
Ms. Goodman Henschitz?
Yes.
Mr. Marmarou?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Ms. Schelnick?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
Seven yeas, no nays.
All right, this evening we have the introduction of two new ordinances, and let me ask Councilwoman Marcia Goodman Henschitz to please read them onto the record.
Okay. A, ordinance authorizing the issuance of a series of bonds in the amount not to exceed $13.5 million, the proceeds of which will be used to refund the city's Series C of 2012 bonds scheduled to mature on or after November 1st, 2027. the refunded 2012 bonds for the purpose of reducing the total debt service over the life of the series. B, ordinance setting the salary of the community development director at $85,312.80 per annum.
All right, thank you, Marcia. We have 5 resolutions this evening. Our first resolution is going to be resolution 80-2019, making City Council 7 appointments to the Charter Review Commission and noting the need for the required report to be filed within six months of their appointment to, as per Charter Section 1203. This was tabled at both the August 12th and August 26th regular meetings. Is there a motion, please?
So moved.
Second.
It's been properly moved and seconded. Are there any comments? Johanny?
I know at a committee of the whole meeting, we were discussing the possibility of adding alternates. I know we're still up for conversation, but just so that if someone falls short or someone realizes within the committee that the work might be overwhelming and they, you know, drop out, that there's a replacement so that the process can continue. Did I summarize it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep. The same.
I just want to inform the public that as of last evening, the appointed individual that I had for District 1 is unable to move forward with that responsibility. So I personally will be looking for a representative who resides in District 1 to serve on this charter committee. So if you personally do not but know, please share that information and have them come in touch with the city clerk's office.
And was that Will?
Excuse me?
Who was that individual, Will?
Oh, Chris.
Chris. Okay, we're going to remove Chris then.
Yeah.
So, just a motion to amend the resolution. Can somebody make that? Will you make it?
Yes, I'd like to make a motion to amend.
To remove Chris?
Second.
All right, we're going to vote on the amendment real quickly. Linda, can we have a roll call, please? Just eliminating Chris at this point.
Motion was made by Councilor Shahelnik, seconded by Councilor Cepeda Freitas. To amend Resolution 80 by removing Mr. Daubert's name from the list of appointees. Ms. Cepeda Freitas?
Yes.
Ms. Goodman-Hinderschitz?
Yes.
Mr. Marmorou?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Ms. Shahelnik?
Yes.
Mr. Twyman?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
7 yeas, no nays.
All right, so we're back to the resolution as amended. Any other comments? Marcia?
I wanted to concur with Johanny's recommendation. The charter review process is a very extensive process that requires everyone to be on board so that the process is understood from the beginning to the end. So I would suggest alternates be considered, and those alternates do not necessarily need, from my understanding, to be adopted by council, but can be encouraged to attend the charter review process so that if any individuals then aren't able to continue with their involvement, that those folks be then ready to be considered by council for appointment at some later date.
All right, any other comments? All right, I think the members that we do have are gonna make a very strong group along with the mayor's appointments. We look forward to them to be able to begin the process. Next year, council is looking to form a government study commission, which is different from the Charter Review Commission, but we felt that doing both at the same time would be rather confusing to the public, first of all, and quite a task. So we look forward to that group launching and look forward to their final results. Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Goodman-Hinderschitz, seconded by Councilor Shalnick, to adopt Resolution 80 as amended. Ms. Goodman-Hinderschitz?
Yes.
Mr. Marmorou?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Ms. Shahelnik?
Yes.
Mr. Twyman?
Yes.
Ms. Cepeda Freitas?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
7 yeas, no nays.
Council, we have 3 resolutions. One's for an appointment and 2 are reappointments. Any opposition to doing them together? All right, I'll read through them. The first resolution is appointing William Vitale to the Environmental Advisory Council. The next resolution is reappointing Pamela Johnson to the Police Civil Service Board. And the next resolution is reappointing El-Sayed Amorzuki to the Police Civil Service Board. Is there a motion, please?
There is.
So moved.
Second.
It's been properly moved and seconded. Are there any comments?
Hey, let's start with Bill Vitale. Here's a man that's been involved in the community, and I don't know how many boards and commissions, and he has actually been going to the meetings of the Environmental Advisory Council, and they finally talked him into coming on board because there is a vacancy. And I think he's going to be a tremendous, tremendous asset to this board. He is involved and he is concerned with one major item. It sounded like plastic. He wants to find out what we can do about plastic here in the city and how it's disposed of. I said he is going to be a very important man on this board. Donna, Marcia.
First of all, I want to be able to reiterate, as far as Mr. Vitale, he's an exemplary person as far as his commitment to city government and had served on the Planning Commission, has attended meetings of the Environmental Advisory Board, and so it's an example of even though you might not be appointed, you can still attend as public, you just don't have a vote, but you can be listening to the process and be ready so when you are appointed, you're at full speed ahead. As far as Ms. Johnson and Mr. Amorzuki, they are just such committed individuals and brought really to light some of the important roles they play with Ms. Johnson, not only being on the Police Civil Service Board, but riding along with the police officers and being able to provide them with support and that spiritual type of guidance that they might need and the real stress that they take on the job, with Mr. Amorzuki being very proactive about making sure that people on the Police Civil Service Board are treated with respect as far as our officers go. So couldn't be two more excellent people. So I fully support their reappointments.
Any other comments?
And I would just echo what's been said. I mean, these three people are exemplary citizens of our city. I wish we had so many, many, many more as wonderful as the three of these folks are, and I am always happy to support the appointments and reappointments of smart, empathetic, energetic people like this.
All right, any other comments?
I don't believe there's any waiting time for these people. We made the approval, if we vote on them, I think they'll be appointed immediately.
Right.
Yeah.
We don't need anybody else's
That's correct.
Approval. Yeah. Thank you.
All right, any other comments? I just want to thank the Nominations and Appointments Committee because they do a lot of legwork, often at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, which is an hour before what we normally start, and we don't get a chance to thank you very often, but it is a lot of work and it's a lot of time going into the interviews and the selection process. So thank you. With that in mind, Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Marmorou, seconded by Councilor Twyman, to adopt resolutions 91 through 93, 2018, which make appointments and reappointments to the city's boards. Mr. Marmorou?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Ms. Shihelnick?
Yes.
Mr. Twyman?
Yes.
Ms. Cepeda Freitas?
Yes.
Ms. Goodman-Hinderschitz?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
7 yeas, no nays.
Linda, was that 81 through 83? You said 91 through 93.
91 through 93.
Oh, is it wrong here on that? Okay, I'm sorry. I was seeing 80 here. I thought.
I don't have resolution numbers on the agenda.
Oh, there's
sometimes you
one on that one.
80, that's yeah.
Right. Oh, 80 is correct because that was tabled.
Okay. Thank you. Sorry.
Yeah.
All right. We have one final resolution, and that is appointing David Hunter as a community development director. Is there a motion, please?
I motion to table.
There's a motion to table. Is there a second to that motion? If not, the motion dies. Okay. Again, we need a motion to move it forward.
So moved.
Second.
It's been properly moved and seconded. Are there any comments, please? No? All right. Okay. I just wanted to welcome David on as a community development director. I think we've all been rather pleased with his performance in the various capacities since he's joined the city. He's hands-on. He helps the administration get a lot of key things done. He's been pivotal in the Dana site and getting us a lot of pivotal information there, as well as the sidewalk program that we voted on this evening. So we welcome him and his skill set into the Community Development Department as the ongoing director. Obviously, the city has a lot of challenges, but we need people who care and can get things done in all our critical path positions. So, Marcia?
Yeah, I just wanted to speak to his capacity for working with community groups, things that hadn't happened for years in the city. When a group started around the South 11th Street area, he was not only willing to come out, sit in the meetings, but he was able to orchestrate and coordinate with other department heads a walkthrough through that neighborhood where the citizens were able to point out their concerns. And what was really spectacular was after those concerns were identified, there was then feedback to the community about what had occurred through a PowerPoint presentation. So it really showed the way that community engagement really needs to continue to occur with the city. So, Mr. Hunter, I fully support the appointment.
All right, if there are no other comments, Lucine?
I fully support this position. Mr. Hunter has, even in his acting capacity, been very professional and has always come through and demonstrated closing, you know, open projects. The sidewalk repair program is a demonstration of that. And I believe will continue. So professionally, he brings an exceptional level to the team, which I think will raise the bar for everybody in our larger team and for our city.
All right. Any other comments? If not, Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Goodman-Hinderschitz, seconded by Councilor Reed, to adopt Resolution 94-2019, appointing David Hunter as CD director. Oops. Ms. Shalnick?
Yes.
Mr. Twyman?
Yes.
Ms. Pater Freitas?
No, I'm sorry. No, I guess I should have had an. I should have made a comment when I should have. No.
Ms. Goodman-Hinderschitz?
Yes.
Mr. Marmaru?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Mr. Walton, President?
Yes.
6 yeas, 1 nay.
Okay, Council, that moves us on to our final order of business this evening, and that's Council comments. If there are any critical items that somebody would like to share with the broader public, now would be the time. Strat?
Yes, the College Heights Community Council had their monthly meeting last night, and we had two speakers there. And the very first one, I think, is very important, what we discussed there with this gentleman. This concerns the recycling program that is going to be set up and has already started in the city of Reading. Now, you're going to get flyers and you're going to get calls and everything else about signing up in this program. They have different size containers and things you got to do, things you can't do, what you can put in there, what you can't put in there. And I think it's important that you fill out this information, and everybody's going to have a number. The container you get is going to have a number on it, and they'll be able to tell when they pick up if that's your stuff or is somebody dumping stuff in there, bringing their stuff over there. And I think it's important. You're going to see the ads and the flyers that are going out. Please respond to them. Okay, the second one, Linda, what was it? The second gentleman.
It was Commissioner Barnhart gave us an update on county issues.
Yes, Commissioner Barnhart was there. And he had a very interesting speech on all the benefits that the county provides for the people in the city and throughout the county. And I think they had a good program there. And if you need any assistance concerning any problems in the county, give them a call and they'll take care of it for you down there. Thank you.
All right, additional comments? We'll go with Johanny, then Donna, and then Lucy.
I just have a question regarding the Afro-Latino celebration on Thursday. At what time?
Johanny.
Ms. Morris, may I ask or no?
Well, you can ask briefly, go ahead.
The time for Thursday's celebration, 5:30.
And where?
We wanted here, the citizens room, but they gave us the third floor.
Okay. So 530, third floor, City Hall Conference Room. Okay. Additional comments, Johanny?
Yes, and also just to again emphasize, the Puerto Rican parade is on Saturday. On the it starts out at City Park, and then it culminates with a celebration on 4th and Penn. So come one, come all. It should be a fun day from 12 p.m. to 6 p.m. And if I may, and just one of the things that I like to always practice and put into place, and I say this often even in my day job, but always remember that teamwork makes the dream work. So I think we've had numerous examples of how when we come together, we're able to get certain things done. I know the 6th Street courtyard, the steps were fixed. They were, I mean, they were broken. It was a hot mess. And, you know, Public Works, Reading Area Water Authority, thank you, Bill Murray. People just came together and collaborated and repaired the steps. So now people are not at risk of falling. So I thank the city and all the other authorities. Again, when we come together, we are able to get so much more done when we work together. So thank you.
Okay, Donna, then Lucy.
Okay. I sit on the government committee of the Census Complete Count Committee for Berks County. I've had a long experience at that, having coordinated that for the 2000 census. And just as an update, there have been concerns because people have seen folks going around the neighborhoods, not just in the city but elsewhere, regarding what is the first major field operation for Census 2020, and that's address canvassing. So you may be seeing someone going through your neighborhood holding up an iPad, taking a picture of your address,
yes,
of your house, of your residence. That's entirely legitimate, but they should be having, if they are questioned, you should be able to see them wearing a badge and a briefcase indicating their affiliation with the Census Bureau. They will explain who they are, they will show their official ID, and they'll explain the purpose of their visit. This is a precursor to the actual Census 2020 complete count, which we all really have to participate in. But just as in any other concern, there are people that are not part of the Bureau who are not official, and if you have any questions and that person does not answer the questions, is not able to verify their affiliation, their identity as a member and an employee of the Census Bureau, please call the non-emergency number of the Reading Police Department, let them know, and the same if you're not a Reading resident but you're in a municipal or regional police department, because we want to make sure that this is done properly, and we want to encourage everyone next April 1st to be a part of the census, to make themselves counted, because each of us represents annually $2,100 of federal funding coming to our municipality, to our county. It involves 32 different programs. If we're not counted, that money goes elsewhere. It should come here through CDBG and a variety of other concerns. We highly encourage the Reading School District to be an active and visible participant in this process. I know there's some concerns on the administration's part over at the school district. We want to make sure that there any concerns they have, any privacy concerns, are addressed. The census information is indeed private. It is not made public for 70 years, so it is probably not a big concern of any of us sitting around this table 70 years from now if somebody sees what happened in the 2020 census. But it is entirely private, and there is no, thanks to the Supreme Court, no citizenship question that will be involved in the census in 2020. Censuses are simply a matter of who is sitting in the United States of America, who is a part of the United States of America on April 1st, 2020. Very important, please be counted.
And Lucy?
Okay, I'm going to try to move through this quickly because there are a lot of things occurring between now and the next public meeting that I want the community to know about. Join us this Friday. Everyone's welcome for a community movie night at the Reading Iron Playground. It starts at 8 p.m. Bring your blankets or your chairs or whatever you'd like. We are deciding between family-friendly movies. We're voting between Hercules and Lilo and Stitch. And then also starting next week on the 17th, which is Tuesday, there will be the 18th Wonder Business Association meeting at 8 a.m. at the Masano Auto Retailers Park. On the 18th, nope, that's just my schedule. On the 19th is our next District 1 community meeting. We will be in the south side of the city, meeting at the Reading Recreation Commission on Spruce Street. So if you remember, we did the 18th ward in the early summer months. Now we're crossing the bridge into the other side of beautiful District 1 and having our community meetings there. All are welcome. Also, I want to congratulate the Penn Street Market for finishing as another successful season downtown. Talking about Bingham Street and Lancaster Avenue, I want to thank my fellow councilwoman, Donna Reed, along with Public Works, Senator Schwenk's office. It took all of us, but we finally got the trees and the overgrowth cleared in the exchange on and off ramps there, which was very dangerous and overgrown. And speaking of ramps, the ramp now is open from the bypass to Penn Street from Route 422 eastbound. So that's been closed for 2 years. So enjoy driving into our beautiful city that way again. And I think that's it for the announcements that I have.
All right. Any additional comments, Marcia?
Okay. First of all, I wanted to follow up just on Johanny's comment. The most hopeful sign I saw, because I work at a building at 6th and Penn, and the steps have been in such deplorable condition for so many years, and you can't tell when you were going from the top of them which ones were damaged. When they put up the police ropes, and that was so necessary, I think it was just a great sign for me that things were going to happen. So. And I know the Board of Authority is going to be helping out with that, so we look forward to that as far as people that need to walk up and down those steps. The other thing I wanted to ask Councilwoman Reed, first of all, thank you for taking the leadership with the census. I'm thinking what might be good is if we could have a picture of what those tags look like for people so they can know how to identify the census workers, that might be helpful. Because people will try to do things that are problematic.
And the complete count committee will be putting information out about that. We'll share, and I know Jamar had asked about sharing the Census Bureau press release about that. I will send that to him, but I will ask Isabel to make sure that that is on our Facebook pages, right, and that we share that through the City Council Facebook pages.
And we do have a vibrant Southern Neighborhood group that will be meeting September 11th at 6:30 at Grace Lutheran Church, and be doing some follow-up thanks to the good work that the city's been able to do as far as going around and looking those properties. And also, it's just been really exciting for me to see the small businesses, the Pagoda Cafe, Bella's Suites. It's like a good place to go to eat sweets and get good food down in that whole sector of the city. So I feel like a mini revitalization has occurred, as well as other sections of the city. I also wanted to just let you know, to keep on your calendar, circle the morning of October the 4th to come up to the Pagoda, because there's going to be some great surprises up there. We're celebrating the Oktoberfest thanks to our partnership with WEU. There's going to be just lots of good food, some entertainment, which I'm going to post on my Facebook, also the city Facebook. If any of you know Alex Metzler, he is just, and I can tell from people smiling, he is just one of the consummate musicians, and he's going to be coming to join us up at the Pagoda. So it's going to be a real buzz once we do all the publicity and such. But we're going to be having fun, and it shows you how you can work together with business partners in the community to make some real good things happen. So I want to thank WEU ahead of time for helping to move that up forward.
All right, any other comments? So a couple of things. First, we wanted to make mention publicly of the update regarding the Bernhard Stand. We're going to be having a public meeting on Wednesday, September 18th at the Chabad of Berks County. It's at 2320 Hamden Boulevard from 6 to 7:30 p.m. And also regarding Egelman's, we're going to be meeting on September 25th at 6 o'clock at the Pagoda. again, regarding both of those dams, Eggleman's is just something we hope to replace, and Bernhardt's, we're still exploring the extent of what that would involve. So we promised the public in both those locations we would do that, so we finally have those scheduled. I just want to comment on the lady about the homelessness, and there is, I literally ran into a woman one night at about 10:30 at night with three young children sitting on a wall, and she told me that she couldn't get into Safe Berks because she wasn't abused. She wasn't a drug user. Her children were well-dressed and well-behaved, and Opportunity House was full. And, you know, at that point I was involved. I found lodge. I got them a room. I fed the kids and everything. I did what anybody would do. But it hit me that, you know, we are exposed.
Yes.
And we've asked the Homeless Coalition to come back to us in what it would cost to operate and do the startup of a triage center so that we can pool all the resources together to help all the homeless people. Mm-hmm. It is a growing problem in the city. It's something we are not ignoring. We appreciate your input. And I'll go back to the hungry people and the homeless people. If somebody's asking you for money for food or for food, mm-hmm. you're involved at that point. And, you know, I know there's always a couple questionable people who it's hard to differentiate what they really want the money for.
Yes.
But to protect those who really need it, often you just have to give them something to help them out. And I've always been my rule of thumb. So it's a tough time for a lot of people. I don't think anybody looks down on anybody else. I certainly don't believe anybody around this table does. I think we care about everybody in the city. That's why we're still here, to make sure that we can help. And hopefully that will resound with the general public as well. Go ahead, Marcia.
And I think one of the roles we all can play, people in the audience here as elected officials, is to really combat the stigma of homelessness, because it always is, there for the grace of God go I. Any of us could face that situation, and it's not only a city issue. I know in one of our local universities, when some of the students are done with their semester, they don't have a place to live anymore, and they live in their cars. And this is just something that is not only in Berks, it's around. One of the things that I think is unfortunate is there's a lot of finger pointing that goes on in a community that says, well, you're not a good community if you have homeless people. We're a caring community, and we will care for our homeless and work with organizations like Berks Coalition to End Homelessness. I was pleased with the meeting we had with them. I think there's some progress that's going to be made, but just like Jeff said, you need to be able to reach out and be there for people who may not have the resources. And unfortunately, it hits more women and children because that's a more difficult population to house. It hits our veterans who sometimes don't know anything but survival techniques. Because I have a lot of wooded areas in District 2, I see a lot of people, you can tell that they've made up a site. Someone came to me outside my workplace. They identified themselves as a former city employee, and I asked them where they were going. They said, oh, I'm going to be going and sleeping in the park tonight. That was their resource. Okay, so it's just a real issue, and if we all can direct our energies to be able to do what we can do to help with it, I think that that's the way we make progress.
All right, Council. Donna?
And I think, you know, we're not in this alone. The situation is far more exacerbated within the city because of the dense population, but it does, as Marcia said, occur in the county as well. And I think the county, and hopefully will be doing as much or even more possible, because mm-hmm. there are empty county facilities out on County Welfare right. Road that mm-hmm. could be used, and one facility in particular that could be easily repurposed and be a wonderful place for women and children who need that helping hand. So I hope the commissioners are listening and can do something.
Okay, real quickly, we have our Finance Committee of the Whole meeting on next Monday night in the Penn Room at 5 o'clock. And then on Monday, September 23rd, we have our Committee of the Whole meeting in the Penn Room at 5 o'clock. And we'll be back here for our next regular council meeting at 7 o'clock. And is there a motion to adjourn?
Got it.
We're adjourned. Thank you.